Hello and welcome to the Zoo City Sportsplex update number 13. Today is September 28th, 2020. You'll see that progress is being made over here. And we're going to take some close-up shots at the way things look today. We had a lot of rain the last little bit here, so we're part of it's underwater this morning. We're able to find some dry area back on the back side where they're working. Over here to the right, there's a fella driving a tractor and a disc, and he's discing up this end here trying to help dry out the surface of the ground a little bit, stirring up the top of the dirt there a little with the disc. This road that you see coming in off of Old Cox Road, this is one of the main entrances into the Sportsplex. Got it graveled in here. And this is area over here. We're looking at the championship ball field right now, which is partly underwater. But here comes the disc. We'll get a close-up of it, turning over that red clay, trying to help dry it out a little bit. That disc looks like it could use some work. See a broken disc or two, and the wheel over there looks like it's about to come off the rim. But it's turning the dirt, which is what he's wanting to do right now. As we look out over the expanse of the area here, we're going to turn our attention over here to the right-hand corner over here. See that white area, that sand. So that's three strips being worked up there for sand volleyball courts. The first one over there, they've already got the sand in there. That's the sand that you're looking at. Each one of those strips will be divided at least into two courts. So there's going to be at least six volleyball courts. Unless they're cutting it into three pieces, but my guess, just looking at it, maybe they're just cut it twice, cut it into two sections, which would make a total of six courts, but I could stand to be corrected on that. I was happy to see Michael Leonard, the city engineer who's kind of in charge of this Sportsplex project. He was on site today and saw me there and came over to talk with me a little bit. So you'll see him here toward the end and land the drone. But he seems like they're pretty pleased with the progress that's being made. See this retaining wall that I showed you a little bit of the last time down here. And they've got a couple other retaining walls. The level of the land drops down to different tiers, and where it drops, they have a retaining wall. You'll see a couple of more over here on the back side in just a minute. This is one level area right here, and to the right of it, where it drops down a level, there's a retaining wall there. Now this is another level, and it comes over and it drops down again, there's a retaining wall being built right down there, down to the next level. They're getting it pretty much down to the level grades that they're looking for, I believe. We'll fly in here to give you a little closer look at these retaining walls they've built. It's the lower one here. And on up above the yellow pan there, you'll see the next one. It rises up to the next plateau. It's a retaining wall. They look really nice. And on out here on the back part of the property is where they had to come back out here to start working, getting some dry enough ground to work on today. So we've got a pan and a dozer out here moving a little dirt. So all this section back here will be worked down too into ball fields. That gives you a pretty good look right there as to how much work has been done on this site so far. They have to work when they can, as far as when the weather will allow. It's supposed to be another chance for showers over the next day or two, so it may get wet again in here. We'll fly back over here to the left front corner again where the volleyball and pickleball court section is going to be. The far left side over here is the volleyball, sand volleyball courts. And then back this way to the right would be where the pickleball courts are, I suppose. We'll square around here and lift the drone up a little higher to give you a little more of a bird's eye view of this section here. So we've got all three strips of this started here. Just waiting on the ground to dry out enough for them to finish it up. There you go. So that's our look for today. Thank you for watching. We'll see Michael Leonard here as we zoom in for a landing here. They've got the water run in and attached to the area. He told me how much water pipe was put in, but I can't remember what all he told me about that. All right, appreciate you watching. I'll see you on the next update. I thought I'd mention to you that when I got over to the Huddle House to eat a little breakfast, I sat at the counter the way I usually do, and a fellow came up behind me and asked if I was who he thought I was, and I said, I believe I am. And we talked a little bit. He's been following the progress, the road work and the Sportsplex by watching the videos. So it's always nice to hear from folks that are watching. Let's know the work I'm putting into this is maybe beneficial in some way. So his name is Randy Ramirez from, I believe, from Seagrove area, he said. So it was good talking with Randy, and just wanted to let you know it's always good to hear from folks that are watching the videos. Thanks a lot. See you next time.